forward. Non-stop, we have a beaten path before us. It was all there in plain sight. Come on, people, we have all seen the signs, so we may never get back to the old school, to the old grounds. It's all about the new found. We are the new.
Hey guys, we are live and welcome to Innycast and welcome to Server Smash. Today's the 7th of June and today we have Waterson versus Ceres. I'll be casting today. My name is Farah and with me I have Odin's Pride. Say hello.
How's it going, guys? Good to be here.
So, Odin's will be helping me cast today. Luya will be our host today. Why don't you take it away, Luya?
Hey guys, welcome to Server Smash. This is one of our last ones before a break, so we're looking to hopefully have a brilliant match here. Finally get to play this match. It's been over a month being postponed, so we finally got Ceres. And...
Waterson?
Waterson, yeah. I'm getting Waterson and Madison completely mixed up at the moment. Sorry, guys. And welcome. Just going to start off by introducing every outfit we have here. Ceres, if you want to start off, if you can, Fuzz, you with us?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, if you want to just go through your outfits, show us go.
Okay, I think the first outfit we need to introduce is Broken Arrow Company, who are quite a fantastic outfit, and I'll let Murdoch tell you all about Broken Arrow.
Alright, sure. As Fuzz said, my name is Mr. Murdoch. I represent the Broken Arrow Company, a TR outfit on Ceres. Basically, we specialize in combined arms warfare using whatever we need to take the objective, and you can find us on the official Planetside 2 forums.
Right, fantastic, Mr. Murdoch. Right, next up, we'll have Outfit 4 and 8, Jenkin.
Yeah, hello guys, this is Jenkin from the Outfit 4 and 8. We are multi-gaming outfit, so if you want to join us on servers or something like that, just hit me up.
Oh, that was short and snappy, that's how we like it. Now here we've got Exosign, who is also going to be quite a key part of the server strategy for this evening. So Exosign, quick bit about who you are, what's Redmist. Yeah, show off a wee bit.
Yeah, hello guys. Exit Sign, representing Redmist on Ceres, mainly infantry-focused outfit. We bring two squads tonight. We talked a lot about this service mesh. Big shout out for Radar X for pulling the right strings to actually make this happen today. So yeah, talked a lot about this. Thanks for this. So we're ready. So bring it on.
Excellent. And next we've got Flying Baconer. Flying Baconer, a wee bit about Foundation, please.
Well, we're a pretty, casual outfit. We focus on having fun more than tactics. And this isn't our first big event, but we have now trained up and ready to go for this one.
All right, fantastic, Baconer. And next... finally, last but not least, the best outfit of all time on Ceres, everyone will surely agree, we've got Winning Duh and Mr. Pintle.
Hello chaps, yes, I'm Pintle from Winning Duh. The outfit is largely formally disbanded. We had quite a talent history on Mallory, made a fairly major impact on the server. I am leaving this up as popular demand dictated, basically. There is no recruitment process to join with Duh. I would recommend several outfits for you if you ever stop by on Ceres. Really looking forward to having a good match today.
Right, and I think that's all the CMS people here. I'll pass on to Watson.
Okay guys, we'll just send Oxymoron. What are you doing?
Okay, well, my name's Oxymoron. I'm the representative for Watson. I also represent TIW, which I'll do first on the list. Our name is the Iron Wolves. We specialize in competitive play. Our aim on the ground, we have some excellent pilots and tankers, but we're mostly infantry-based. If you want to find us, you can look us up on the PS2 forums recruiting thread. Next on our list is Threegis.
Hi, I'm Alain Badiou from Aegis Initiative, also commonly known as Threegis. We are an infantry-based outfit that specializes in point lockdown. We have a website, 3gis.us, if anyone's interested.
All right, next, DD12.
Hey guys, I'm Morcam from DD12. We're a fairly serious TR infantry outfit. We spend a lot of time on live and organized ops, drop and hold kind of stuff. And we have a strong future interest in a competitive team. If you're interested in joining, you can contact me, Morcam, on live, or you can look up our forum thread. Thanks, guys.
XOO.
We are XOO, Zen of Onslaught. We are a multi-gaming community founded in PS1, mainly focused in infantry, but definitely some good vehicle players. We are an 18-plus outfit, and you can find us at XOOHQ.com.
IRNG.
Hey guys, I'm Shuck from the Ironclad Rangers. We are a TR Watterson outfit that focuses on small-scale squad cohesion and cooperation. We try and focus on that small element of change in the battle that can really turn the tide. If you're interested in joining us, you can find us at ironcladnation.com, or you can check our forum post on the official forum for how to get in contact.
Next is Armar.
Hey guys, my name is Devastator. I lead Republic Marines, or RMAR. We're mostly an infantry-based outfit with combined arms tactics with Prowlers and Mosquitoes. Anyway, if you're interested in joining us, just send me a tell. We're pretty selective, so just gotta be a cool person. That's pretty much it. Thanks.
I believe that is it for Watterson.
Okay. cheers, guys. If you want to go back to your channels, and there will be an all call once a match starts.
Just prior, some prior warning.
Just to clarify on something, are we starting in the amp station or in our warp gate?
You will be starting
probably
in the amp stations.
In the amp station, we just clarified this.
You can pull whatever you like as long as you are in the amp station.
Good luck, guys.
Thanks.
Okay, Odin, it's you and me now.
Wonderful, just how we like it.
Ah, yeah, yes.
No homo.
You beat me to that. So, we're just going to explain the rules for the population out there.
Certainly. So this time it's going to be a little bit smaller than what some viewers might be used to. It's going to be 96 v 96. We got two full platoons, and we have... we are still on Ezmir. It's going to be between the lanes of Eli Amp Station and not Amp Station. For those of you who are looking at the map, that's going to be towards Ymir and up towards the Octagon and Isa. Those are going to be the boundaries. We cannot go beyond Isa Tech Plant, and you cannot go beyond the amp stations. Obviously, if an amp station is taken, the home base is taken, that is a victory condition, and the match stops immediately. So it looks like we have a few lanes that we can start off on immediately from each amp station. From Knot, you can go down south to Knot Communications, which the VS already hold. And then you have Geological Survey and Frostfall Overlook, and then you have Ymir. Which Ymir is
Eastern
that?
Way Station.
Eastern Way Station, yes.
So
and
I think
you have the Biolab.
We'll just explain some of the rule set up here. The basic win conditions, there's two main win conditions in this two-hour game. One is to take the enemy capital, which in this instance is the opposing amp station. The second is there are 19 territories in contention here. We're not including Knot Research Camp, and we'll explain why that's already VS in a second, which means there will not be... It's quite a bit quieter. Thank you, Jessica. I'll fix that in a second.
So yes, like he was saying, there's going to be 19 territories, so we cannot have a tie. The Knot Communications is already in VS hands. The reason for that is so that each side has three connecting territories to Ymir, as opposed to one side having four versus three, and then having Eli Amp Station having a 4-minute head start
exactly.
On attacking the Biolab. So.
So the basic reasoning for Knot Research Camp, as you said, was that it's a 12-minute timer until you can get to the Ymir Biolab 4, 4, and 4 for the different outposts. So it just makes it fair and balanced. To reiterate who is casting, I am Farah from Anycast and Odin's Pride. Who are you from?
I'm from the Dread Legion, and we are a TR outfit on Connery.
Right,
okay. Look forward to seeing you some more.
So anyway, the point is that there are two essential lanes. You've got the southern lane and you have the northern lane leading between the two amp stations. The ISA Tech Plant is up for grabs as well. ISA Southern Camp, ISA Tech Plant, and ISA Mountain Pass are not worth anything, however. They are simply there that if you want to commit resources and infantry or troops or whatnot to take the Tech Plant, then your reward is main battle tanks. But it does not have an impact on the outcome at the end of the game. And then the other issue... That's very important is that each territory is worth the same. Ymir Biolab is worth the same as Sia's Echo Valley Substation. All the territories are balanced, so it's 19 territories that are up for contention, and then that's just basically it. There's no weight, Ymir isn't worth 5 small outposts, it's just 19 territories. Whoever owns the most territories at the end of the 2 hours wins, or you have to take the amp station.
This is a very different format from a lot of things that that some longtime viewers may have seen before. So obviously this is still the test season. So I'm really excited to see, how this plays out, especially with the ISA lane, because, essentially it's how much does one server prioritize having that extra armor push, with those MBTs and things like that. And, since the fact that we don't have that weighted system with large outposts and with the facilities, it'll be interesting to see if the strategies perhaps change depending on the fact that we don't have that weighted system. So I'm really excited to see what Ceres and Watterson are able to come up with now that we have these different rule sets in place. And I'll be interested to see if some of this comes into play at maybe some later matches as well.
Well, yeah, I mean, looking at the map, I can already see that the main choke points are going to be, they're both going to get to the biolab at the same time. So that could be a quick 3-minute hack. They are both going to get to their Octagon and Sarah listening post, large outposts, at the same time, which means Echo Valley substation will be the main crunch point. But at the same time, hypothetically, they'll get to the tech plant at the same time. One thing we might see is that there's a lot of territory in the way. It could be up to 12 minutes before we even see land forces engaging each other, at least where they can contend for a base. So I expect to see a lot of air pooling at the beginning. But one thing I'm definitely hoping to see today is interdiction tactics, meaning that, for example, if I'm Vanu, I might go to the bulwark at the beginning and drop a squad on the capture point, simply so that when NC moves to LE Forest Pass, captures it, because it's uncontended, then the VS hold off the NC at the capture point at Bulwark for even just like 3 minutes would mean that they would get to the biolab uncontested and would be able to capture it before the NC even got there.
Yeah, I mean, just the fact that these points aren't necessarily under contested or aren't contestable at the outset does not mean that people won't be fighting over some of these points. It'll be really interesting to see who prioritizes what in these instances off the bat.
And it's interesting to see how much air is going to be pulled and how much they dedicate to air at the time as well. So I'm looking forward to this. So we're going to show you another video that just got released for the E3, and then we'll be right back and we'll have a little bit more chat about this.
All right, see you soon.
I stand among fallen comrades.
The cost of the battle will take their toll.
But in the absence of all hope,
I will remain vigilant.
I will not fail my brethren.
I will make any sacrifice that is necessary.
Our time is now.
Go, 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 go! Go, let's move, let's move, let's move!
The battle is here.
It's time for war.
Okay, the charge now. They're coming down. Max, there you go, there you go, there you go. There now. Stand on it, there you go. Nice work, high four ball.
Whatever your allegiance,
however you choose to fight.
Keep in mind what is most important.
We must fight together
to survive.
So that was admittedly a trailer for PlanetSide 2 on the PS4, but I thought it was pretty good because it emphasized elements such as team play and coordination, and you know, that's exactly what Server Smash is.
Yeah, for a second there, I thought that it was definitely they were using our footage, but I don't know. I think we would have to be owed royalties or something like that. I haven't seen a check yet. Where's my bonus check?
Yeah, well, there's. I think they have their own team that do that kind of stuff. I can't honestly say it's all staged or whatnot, but it does look very pretty. So I'd love to see that being of that quality on the PS4, hopefully. Anyway, so moving back to this map scenario, right? The number of air terminals that can pull air forces are really limited to really the bases and, you know, the Weimar Biolab. Can you see where we've had in previous casts that terminals, air terminals, were destroyed, forcing the team going back to the warp gate? Could you see that as being a tactic that might be in use today?
I mean, in terms of this instance, with the extra time that it would take to go from warp gate to, say, Ymir, I mean, the time between Knot and Ymir and the warp gate in Ymir is probably only about 30 seconds. Now, to some people, that may seem like a very small time, but I mean, in terms of actual gameplay, you can probably lose about 6 Mozzies in 30 seconds. So it's, if people want to leave a person or an engineer at the amp station to make sure those things don't go down, then that's up to them. But if somebody is able to infiltrate and hack out their own home base or their enemy's home base, then, you know, you probably have bigger issues at that point.
Mm. Well, I guess one thing we should mention here, which is somewhat important, is that today the two servers are, as we said, Waterson versus Ceres. Waterson being a US server and Ceres being an EU server. It's 96 versus 96. The other important element is that Waterson today is the Eastern Warp Gate. That means Waterson will be playing Vanu and Ceres will be playing New Conglomerate NC. It's quite an important thing telling you who's who. All right, so just thought we'd get that out of the way.
Something else important that I don't think we've mentioned is due to the SOE testing for E3, some of the changes that they have made have actually resulted in vehicles being essentially free resources as well as maxes. So you can pull a max and it won't cost you anything, except for as long as you lose it, you still have to wait on a timer, I would assume. But it's not going to cost you any resources to pull that extra tank or to pull that extra galaxy at all.
Wait a second, guys. Just need to make an all call. Just Lou, you're on all call. Just to say, there's 9 minutes left until match start. If people can start gathering up into the amp stations, 9 minutes to match start.
So, as you're saying about the PTS, they're using Amrish right now as a showcase in E3 for the consoles. And very gratefully, as you also mentioned or was mentioned in the interviews, the devs opened back up Esimir and admittedly Indar as well in Hossen so that we could have the server smash today. However, we are under certain sort of demonstration or preview rules, meaning that all vehicles are free. All maxes are free. This is why the whole map is red, essentially, or neutral, because the resources don't matter. What matters, because you don't need resource gain, I should say, because everything's free. The only thing that's not free, however, is consumables. So C4, grenades, sticky grenades, all that type of consumable stuff, that actually costs, and you're not going to be replenished as much. So it's going to have to be careful in infantry fighting. But, I foresee lots of maxes. If C4 is going to be limited and conch grenades and avine grenades and all that's going to be limited because you're going to have your pool of 40 and that's about it, there's going to be max.
Do you want a little bit of max with your max pull?
You know, there may be max. So we'll wait and see what happens. I mean, Vanu versus NC New Conglomerate max. Do you have any preference?
Speaking as a TR, I don't like either of them, so...
Yeah, see, the NC Max just says, hug me. That's all it says.
No, I mean, okay. going back to what you said, guys, I know that there are a lot of things that that we work together on with SOE, but this time they really stepped up for us. So, I mean, everybody needs to go out and actually give them the respect that they deserve, because without them actually going out of their way for us today, you wouldn't be seeing the match that you're seeing today, and both Ceres and Waterson, as well as the whole Service Smash organization, give a really big thank you to both RadarX and the whole dev team at SOE for making this whole possible. So thank you guys.
I also expect this to be quite air heavy, because if there's no reason to lose air resources after your two or three, you can just keep pulling air again and again and again for the whole 2 hours, which as a spectator, it's pretty cool. But from a tactical point of view, admittedly this is a smaller scale battle, so resources are split. When it's a whole continent side game, you can play strategically and go after certain resources and throttle your enemy off. But in this one, it's a slightly more simplistic setup where it's dominate the enemy, and then the only thing you have to be concerned about is if you're air dominating, is that once your enemy's on timer, on vehicle timer, then you can just camp hypothetically at their air spawn terms. You know, there's certain bases that can pull air alternatively, and at the worst case scenario, then the enemy has to come from the warp gate. We'll have to see whether or not they use it to the same effect that, let's say, Matheson did against Miller. Now, did you watch that game? Yeah, you were casting with me. How dominant that was. So we'll see how effective if it is today at all. And also, I'm looking forward to seeing what kind of vehicles.
I think it was Miller Cobalt, wasn't it? It wasn't the Matheson Cobalt. It wasn't the Matheson.
But it was the reverse. When it was Miller Matheson, Miller went heavy air, but it didn't feel as if it was being as effective on the ground. But right, so I guess taking a tangent here, what about the hypothetical third lane? The ISA Southern Camp, the ISA Mountain Pass, and the ISA Tech Plant. They're not worth anything capture point-wise or territory-wise, but they're worth the tech for main battle tanks. Do you put people into that? I mean, do you actively try and push that, or what? How would you go with this?
To me, it's really a question of game theory. I mean, if the other side pushes for it, then I as a commander need to push for it because you can't let them have it for free. But if they don't push for it, does that mean that do I need to push for it, and do I push for it because I think I can get it for free? So it's really a prisoner's dilemma on many different levels.
At the end of the day, you're going to take the Octagon and you're going to take Sarah listening post regardless, because you're just naturally progressing towards each other. You may try and interdink to slow down the enemy so that you can get to the tech plant first. Because hypothetically, even though the Octagon's 4 points and Sarah listening points 3, you get to the tech plant at the same time. So when the ISA tech plant comes into contention, it's a 7-minute cap. That first 3.5 minutes doesn't really matter who's capping, because it just essentially turns the base neutral from TR, third faction, to beginning of NC or beginning of VS. And then when that starts, you can hypothetically then send a team in to the tech plant, assuming you've got a link. But at the end of the day, it comes down to you need to at least get your ISA Mountain Pass or your ISA Southern Camp just to give you the option of going to the tech plant. That's super important.
Yeah, I wouldn't try and do any interdiction at ISA Southern or at ISA Mountain. But if people are, if I'm looking at the map and I see that there's 24 or 48.
Mrs. Lee, you're on all call. 5 minutes to match start, guys. 5 minutes.
Hold on, let's just check the time to the next resource tick.
It'd be a fresh tick, so we'd be looking at...
Right now. That's 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Perfect.
So do one more all call and just say on the next resource tick we start.
Okay, guys, this is Lou, you're on all call. As raised 5 minutes, your next resource tick will happen in precisely 5 minutes. Match will be starting as soon as the resource tick completes. Match will be starting as soon as resource tick completes.
Right, so with that being said, we'll just do our last video, which is our server smash intro, and then we get ready for the game.